as comfortable as possible. Second night in the woods and continuing the story of May. A cat returning home after leaving college and discovering how her small city has changed. As powerful and important as kindness is to give to others, it is of utmost importance that we give it to ourselves. Especially when we are finding it hard to relax or hard to fall asleep. So again, I ask you to try to make yourself as comfortable as possible, to let the tension fall from your shoulders and your brow, and your jaw, and to let all of that tension drop down your body and out your feet and into the earth ourselves to see others with kindness and an open heart. And when we don't see others that way, when we don't ascribe some kind of value to the lives others, we end up doing some very terrible things and can be guided by the worst parts about ourselves. But I guess Aunt is recommending we leave the scene and hopefully are safe on the way. So this is B, who works at the old to talk about it. last night. I really thought you were coming home tonight. You know me with the bad memory. Yeah, I remember. I mean, you do pretty well. Yeah, I remember to eat and breathe. You're really good at, like, remembering how to walk. I'm a champ. Tell you what, how about we pretend I did come home tonight, and we just got back from the bus station. Start over. Yeah. Okay. By the time we're able to emancipate ourselves from them, it seems like they don't have much left to give. I don't have any children, but the people that I do know that have children so much to them. See if we can find something more out about that arm. There are a few things hanging around in here from the old country. This clock, the trunk in the storage room, and whatever is buried under the house after the cement incident. The cement incident. I wonder what that refers to. Hey, hon. Yeah. Come say hi. Say hi. sounds like fun, honey. Yeah, I guess. You don't sound too happy about it. Okay, well, I'm off to find Angus. Have a good time, daughter. Thanks, 24-hour mom. 7 days a week. Her mom seems like a nice cat. Hey, you kid. Uh-oh. Adult. So you're back, eh? Yes, Mr. Benderson. Didn't last long, eh? Similar. No, Mr. Benderson. You get a job yet? Yes, I've been elected mayor. Couldn't do worse than the current one. And I've ordered your house to be bulldozed. What? Finishing the job you started? I hope you enjoy living in the woods. Those eggs took the paint off the vinyl siding. Scavenge food. Commune with the beasts, Mr. Benderson. Watch yourself, Lil Miss. Lil effing Miss. No one's forgotten who you are and what you did, you know. They may act like they have, but that's just small town polite right there. Is that what this is? Small town polite's all you got, kid. So watch it. Well, that was really interesting, but I need to go listen to my cells die. Bah. Bah. So, I guess May is quite notorious in this town for some destructive behavior. Egging people's houses, beating up classmates, maybe even setting fire to something. I'm not sure that has yet to be determined. You ain't changed since you was a kid. Yeah, it seems everyone knows May is a mischief maker. Which is a very important role to play in a community. Shake things up, keep people on their toes. To test the stability. Society. So we're going to look for Angus, who is the third member of the band, Greg, Angus, B, and May. And I suppose he must work at some kind of tech repair shop. Video outpost 2. I think that's where sounds like the ocean in here. I suppose it would. That's great, dude. You see Angus? Every night. Yeah, I meant like, where is Angus right now? At work, at the video store. Oh, okay, see. used to. So maybe I'll ask him again. Where's Angus? Oh, he works day shift. Is it day? I got here early. Any idea where he is? I assume he went home. He lives next door. Go inside and ring the buzzer. Wait, why does everything you say sound like a question? I have the same question. You do the same thing. I just don't comment on it. You get a lot of people selling you stuff. All right, they did not want to talk to us. Hi, Angus. Angus, you say? Dude, it's May. Tell me about yourself, Maybelline. This isn't Angus. Would you like it to be? Nope, bye. Ooh, this is... guess this is a new apartment for them. And May does not seem to want to ask him about how to get in to the apartment. Oh, there's that fox. Generation Fiasco. Fiasco. The stairs. I don't understand why I can't open the door to the stairs. I guess it would be locked. At least from the outside. Although, because I could interact with so many parts of that buzzer, someone will tire of my button pressing to the point that they'll let me in. Let's try this one again. There's got to be some way to make this work. No button. Yeah, you can like stick a screwdriver in and, well, it's too late now. Come on up. I wonder if there really was a screwdriver somewhere we could have used. Well, I'm glad I was not too badly damaged by the shock. Well, hello, Angus. Whoa, come right in. Hey, dude. Welcome to our apartment. smart guy, gave me some magical ones and zeros. I am by no means a computer whiz, but I wonder what sort of file could be on this USB that works so perfectly to fix the computer. But here we go. Oh my gosh. It's fixed. I guess it turned out okay then, your computer. Yeah, it did. Thanks. I put something else on that drive. Do you remember Demon Tower? Oh yeah. I used to play that all the time, like 10 years ago. I've been playing it. Okay, please. Okay, whatever. Yeah. spend all this time playing here, but I don't know if there's much else to do in this day. It was already nostalgia of playing video games that you played as a child is really unbeatable. Let's see if he's got anything to say. Oh, he's heard about my mayoral election. So he knows who Angus is. In the old days, I used to work with his dad, he says. I know they fell on some hard times after we all got laid off. Used to see him at the bar. So I guess that there was a factory or something that they're not letting me go back outside. I suppose it's time for bed. A common story here. Oh, by the way, B works at the old pickaxe, so you can go there, get some tools, lol. Big axe and go on a rampage. It's nice that my friends support my destructive tendencies. At least Greg seems down. Saw them running around before. Yeah. steal things. Holy crap, I was fooled. I don't know if I've encountered them yet. If we don't start getting businesses in here, there ain't gonna be a possum spring. So we gotta do whatever we can do to get the market to notice us. Can we get back to the topic at hand? Yeah, so we allocate funds to preserve the statue of Gary. You're not hearing me. Don't tell me I'm not hearing you, Andrew. It's not of sufficient historical note. Your ass is not of sufficient historical note. Guys, stop this. This is the stoplight fight all over again. Oh yeah, and remember who won that one. Can we move on? Fine. It's tough to end conversations like that when everyone has an opinion about how things should change. But we all share very little actual power to change things. And I think that frustration is easy to turn on the people closest to us, because sometimes it's all we have is to speak to someone that is already there. What you doing up there? Streetlight got tore off in the big storm a few days back. Don't help that idiots keep jumping on it. That's a shame. Spread the word to the other kids, adults. Oh, I don't think so. Adults got jobs and better things to do anyway. Anyway, you tell those other kids to lay off, gonna get themselves or somebody else killed. So an adult is defined by their job, or their having moved on from doing things like jumping on street lamps. The way to the church is blocked. I think I had recognized that before. This is Fat Pocket Pawn. Tell us soft while getting on the boards. Cold comfort. I'm just always on edge. Maybe see someone to talk about this. This is the coffee and cigarette couple. Still trying to get on the board. He fixed my leg last week. He treated my babies through chicken pox and strep. I know. I just... whatever. Cigarettes. Oh, here it is. I guess I had passed it before. The old pickaxe. Yeah, Bill, write it up as on the clock. She's not gonna like that. I don't care if she doesn't like it. It was her fault. That is time extra we charge for that. Alright then. Hey B. Housework. Stressful. End of the month coming up, and I have to start ordering in winter stuff. Which means I have to bribe one, or hopefully two of the guys, to unload the trucks. Because I'm not carrying in a truck full of rocks all by myself. Well, Greg asked me to ask you if you would drive us to the party tonight. Let's see what she says. You know, the one up in the state park. B does not seem thrilled. Going down on any given night in Possum Springs, you were referring to. Are you being sarcastic? I'll drive. Great, thanks. At 8:30. Be ready, or we'll go without you. I'm starting to think B just has a more gruff way of speaking that makes it hard to understand that she's still out. choose the options screen again. Well, I guess B is gonna drive us. That's nice of her to do. And it looks like she has a tougher job than Greg does. At least, there seems to be a little more to be responsible for there. Maybe we'll check in with Greg here again before we head back home. See if he's got anything more to say about getting ready for the party in the woods. I didn't end up buying an axe. Respect people's space and the ways that the different ways that we all was just stopping by to see how you were doing after the other night. May, a lot of things that happen around here, sometimes in town, sometimes out by the tracks, sometimes up in the hills. It's my job to make sure folks like you never see something like what you saw the other night. It's my hope.